So again, hello, I'm sorry if you already heard this a million times, but my name is Cindy Sullivan and I am a senior fitness specialist and personal trainer. We're here with week 5 of Power Pedal. So I'm gonna focus on our total body with a little warm-up stretch, a little cardio and endurance, and I'm gonna do a big chunk on balance today, but I'll still incorporate strength and we'll do floor. So I want you to stand up nice and tall, really starting out with the breathing. Most important is form and breath, breathing in through the nose, exhale, blow it out, tighten up that core. So breathe in through the nose, expand the rib cage, blow it out empty, tighten it up in there. Ready? Here we go. Breathing in, blowing it out, sip back into those heels. So breathe in through the nose, exhale, sip back into the heels, way back there. So I'm already gonna start to get that whole body moving. Nice. So just remember, modify this class for you. Everyone's at different levels. Don't do anything that hurts. Drink water when you want to. And most importantly, have fun. Good, one more time. Bring both arms up. I'm gonna have you keep those arms up. If you can, interlace your fingers, push your palms to me, lift them right up, and then lean to one side. Now, if you can't get into this stretch, just let one arm go and just relax there for a moment. This is a little deeper with the push. Come on back up, over to the other side. Same thing, let one arm go if you can't stay in that, if it's uncomfortable. Good, come on back. Now we're all gonna let one arm go. Let the right ear fall to right shoulder. Keep that elbow back, relax your neck. Let it fall over to the side. Nice, bring it on all the way to the other side, keep the elbow back. So I'll continually talk about posture, opening the chest, keeping the core nice and tight, and back over. And now you're gonna swing it back again. And back. So flow through this now, nice stretches. One more time up and over. Both hands come down to the floor, we're gonna roll out those shoulders. So here we are, standing tall. Keep your knees nice, slight bent. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Shoulders come up, back, and down. So I always try to work on posture, keeping that chest open. When we're biking, a lot of times we are hunched over. So I wanna open your chest up. Good stretch for us all. And then roll it forward. But this time, don't bend forward. Just think about those shoulder blades back there coming apart. So roll it forward, good. Both arms are gonna come up now. I'm gonna do a hip hinge, wake up that midsection. So we're gonna fold in half, come all the way down, unfold, right back up. So these are folds at the hip, not at the waist. So folding at the hip, come all the way down, unfold, right back up. Do it again, one more time. We'll continue to stretch out and warm up as we go along with class. Hands come on the thighs. I'm just gonna have you get that back, lower spine, belly button to the spine, and then drop it to the floor. So tuck that tailbone under, and then drop it down. Adding breath, exhale, look at your belly button, inhale, drop it down, look up. So we're gonna warm up the mid back, the lower back, the glutes, the legs, good. You can even add the neck in, drop it down. Good, two more times, up. Last one. Let those fingers fall. Now you're gonna roll it up. Stack the spine one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders, neck, head. Last, come up tall. Good. I'm gonna have you open that chest up again. Roll it up. Now I'm gonna have you bring the arms with it. Bring the elbows back. Really open, squeeze those shoulder blades together. And then we're gonna do a backstroke. Big arm back. 2, 3, and 4, we're gonna roll the shoulders forward, just little, and then make it bigger. Bring those arms all the way up and around. I'm really gonna stretch out, adding mobility into the shoulders, and then we're gonna do a big swim stroke forward. 2, 3, and 4. All right, you guys ready? We're gonna start a march, okay? So we're still gonna stretch out, but I'm gonna add a little cardio element into this. If you want, you do not have to march. You can just pump your arms. Okay, I wanna make sure we're building endurance through our weeks, even though we're focused on a lot more strength, okay? Endurance is so important, making sure we have that stamina ride our bikes. It's great if we can get on it, but we gotta be able to ride it. All right, so come on. March it out if you want, or just pump those arms. Come up overhead. We're just gonna raise that heart rate a little bit. So then when we're working, we're gonna get stronger throughout the workout. If we're warmed up, really good. Good, bring those arms back down. Arms come out to the side. I'm gonna do palms up and down, palms up and down. So I want you to think wrists right here. We're gonna get right into holding those handles. So adding in the march, we're kind of doing this like double duty stuff. We're gonna get wrists stretched out, muscles strong around the joints. Good, now add a little more twist. Now forearms come up to the ceiling, forearms to the floor, right here, up and down. So twist right there. Now add the shoulder roll, roll it out. Good, add in that mobility in. Good, we're gonna clap in front. So clap in front, open, squeeze. Good, use those fingers, wiggle them around while you do this, and squeeze. Good, open, open. One more time, hold it in front, open, close with the fingers. 8, 7, squeeze, 6, 5, grip, grip. 2, roll wrist, roll it back. Do it again, reverse, and back. Keep the arms out, march it out. So we're gonna keep that cardio going. If anyone needs a drink yet, grab it now. I'll stay here for a couple seconds. If you don't need it, keep those legs up. If you can get the legs a little higher, right here. We're only doing 2 songs of cardio. You can do this. Arms come right back up. I'm gonna have you touch the elbows in front. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, do it again. Try to think elbows. We're working muscles we don't typically work. 5, 6, I'm gonna have you keep your arms out to the side. You're gonna do muscle man in and out. Good. Get those joints going in the elbows, keeping the heart rate up, stretching out and getting stronger. Keep going. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, bring it on down. I'm gonna have you do a march side to side now, okay? So this is gonna be a little fast. If it's too fast for you, just do small side to side steps. Okay, so if you can go a little wider, try to go wider. So I like to do side to side in here. This is lateral, really good for biking. Again, building that strength. We talked about this in the beginning, strength for the glutes and the hips. Now I'm gonna kind of do this neuroplasticity, sounds crazy, but it's muscle mind stuff. Good for agility as we get a little bit older, keeping that muscle mind connection. So I'm just doing a bicep curl with a side to side. It's too fast, slow it down, just keep it right here. Good, now I'm gonna have you swing your arms side to side. So we're just playing around with moves to get that heart rate up, but also I'm still stretching out those joints and muscles. Okay, keep going right here. All right, I'm gonna do another one that I'm gonna be using later on. So this is called upright row. So we're gonna just be pulling those elbows to the side and wrists stay lower than the elbows. So right here, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, arms overhead, pull it down. So designed to confuse you a little bit. It's on purpose. Don't worry if you don't have it. We're only staying here a couple more seconds. 4, 3, bicep curl again. 8, 7, 6, 4, 3, swing those arms, go out. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, upright row again, pull it up. Good, stay with it. You're getting stronger, I promise. Those side to side moves are so good. That heart health. Arms overhead, pull it down. Now really keep that chest open. Again, I'm telling you, posture. Keep it up. So good for the bike. Nice. 3, 2, keep those feet side to side. Stay with me, you're almost done. I'm gonna have your hands follow your feet. Now, if you want to, I want you to really stretch those muscles. Get those arms way up overhead. Anytime the hands come over the heart, it keeps that heart rate up, builds that stamina. You got it. 4, three. Now we're gonna bend over and sweep our toes. It's a U shape, so it's a little U, side to side. For eight, seven, six, five, four, three, up overhead again. So we're gonna go up, ready? Up, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now you, come on. So hold that belly and don't let your belly hang down there. Keep it tight, but make sure you're breathing. Come on. Four, three, overhead. Last time for eight. Bring it up. Up. Three, five, six. Last time for the U. Bring it down. Sweep the toes. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. March it out right here. Stay with me if you can. We'll finish off this song strong. Good. Get back out there with those arms. We're gonna do little circles. Look fingertip to fingertip. Draw a circle around there. Get bigger and bigger. You got it. Nice. Big as you can go. Nice. Keep going. Two, one. And then we're gonna go backwards. So that upper body should be super stretched. I'm gonna move us into lower body. Open those arms again. One, two, three, and you did it. Excellent. See that? I knew you could. Grab some water. Grab a chair. Okay, I'm gonna get a sip. So you're not gonna sit in your chair yet. I'm just gonna use the chair for safety while we're doing our balance stuff. Okay, so we're gonna start with a little ankle strength, and this is good for balance. So feet are about hip width apart. Get that form. Form is really important to me. Keep your core tight. Make sure your butt's not sticking out. Kind of tuck it under a little bit so you're nice and tall. Chest stays open, shoulders down. Heels come up and down, okay? Whew, so think string, pulling your head straight up and down. Nice. So you're strengthening those ankles, those calves, those legs, and it's so important. Big muscles for balance, okay? Good. Straighten it up. Three, two, and one. All right, I'm gonna have you hold it up here if you want to. Both arms come up, shoulders down. Lift it up there, hold it up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, bring it on down. All right, I'm gonna do double time, okay? So this is our last one of these. Keep your arms up if you want, hold on if you need to. Here we go, fast heels, fast. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and bring it down. Great job. All right, let's find our balance before we move on, okay? So I'm gonna have you lift one knee up. So here's our progression, four different ways to do it. Hold on, let go if you can. Crisscross if you want to try it. And then the last progression is closing your eyes, but stay safe. Make sure you're near a chair if you try it. It's just if everything else is too easy, that's the last one. All right, come on out of that. So remember, core is tight, nice and engaged, contracted, let go if you can, crisscross if you want to try. And then the last one is closing your eyes. Good. All right, what we're gonna do next is roll out the ankle. We did a lot of already heel raises, so we wanna keep it nice and mobile. Point your toe, keep your leg up as high as you wanna go, but stay tall. Now let go if you want, hold on if you need to, roll out that ankle. And reverse. I don't think I need to tell you how much you're working those ankles and legs in biking. Okay, so you're needing to use a lot of power down there. So you wanna keep it nice and flexible as well as mobile. Flexibility and mobility are a little bit different, but tied together. Other foot, come on up, roll it out. Three, four. So we wanna keep flexibility, but mobility through those joints. Nice, and then reverse. Especially in here, we're gonna be doing some leg work today. That's gonna take a lot of body weight on the ankle. So let's do this now. Let's get ready for that. All right, come on out of that. So let's do some of our balance work, okay? So we're going to start, do our balance challenge. I've been doing this every week, so see how you progress. 8 second hold up and down for eight, and then 8 second hold with that knee. You ready? Here we go. Let go if you can. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, down and up for eight. Ready? Down, lift from the knee. 2, lift, 3, lift, 4. Nice. 5, 6, 7. Hold this one up. Keep it up there. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and you did it. Woo, how'd you do? Let's do the other side. Okay, so keep that knee up there, core's engaged. Spotting helps. If you look at one spot, that always helps you. Stay there. All right, you ready? Down and up for 8. So if you don't need to touch the floor, don't. If you need to put it down in between, it's okay. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and hold this one up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right. So I'm going to do the open the gate one. We've done this a little bit, so we're just quickly going to do this one again because I like to build. Okay, so right foot stays on the floor, left toe is on the floor. Open and close. Hold on if you need to. Let go if you can. Here's your progression. You're either going to stay with me here, or now you can move it up. Open and close. So we're working on external rotation. You know you need this for biking, getting that leg up and over. Okay, and then if you want to even progress that, let that foot stay in one spot away from the leg, open and close. So you're trying to keep your hips, body straight ahead, but just that knee opens and closes. So you can keep that foot stabilized on the floor if you need to do this. This is the advanced one. Good, other side. So I'm telling you, it's almost like you're lubricating those joints. Okay, these are just moves you don't do naturally during the day. So this is a great class to work on this. Other foot, left foot down, right toe on the floor, knee opens and closes. It seems so simple, but we never do it. Good, and then you can progress this if you want. Put your foot up against your knee, open and close. You can do this holding on. And then to progress this one, you just lift your foot out to the side, open and close. Nice job. One more. Excellent. All right, so I'm gonna stretch us out really quickly. Another really good one to do all the time for biking is stretching. My next 2 weeks are gonna be extra flexibility, so we'll be doing extra stretching. But today, you're gonna walk those glutes back, back, back. See my feet? So try to get your feet under your hips. And then this is a total body stretch where you're just gonna look down at the floor. Your ears are gonna try to get towards your shoulders or in between your arms. And I want you to find length through your spine. You should think about this, okay? So think about really lengthening through your spine, letting that chest come down. Now, if it feels good, you can shift your body weight into the right heel. Right. And left. Good. Now it's a little bit of a more of a wag of a tail. So you're just kind of shifting your body weight, but your hips are going side to side, and it should feel good on that lower back. Okay. Good. Stop here. Arch your back. Roll it up. All right, so I'm gonna move us on. Now we're still doing balance, but I'm gonna add strength to it, okay? I'll show you the move and then you can decide if you want weight. I'm gonna do what's called a bow and arrow with a weight, okay? So you're gonna be having a staggered stance. The weight's gonna pull back. So if you don't want the weight, you don't need it. Here's what we're gonna do. If you need a chair to hold on, you can't do a staggered stance. Put the chair on the left, step forward with your left. So this is the position. It's a staggered stance. So we're already doing balance. Hold the chair. Hand up. You don't need the chair. Left hand up. Bend that left knee a little bit. We're going to bring the elbow back like a bow and arrow straight out. Okay. So I want you to use your core to hold yourself in place. Here we go. Pull it back. So you are balancing right now. We're working some muscles that you don't typically work. A nice push and pull move again. For chest, shoulders, bicep, tricep, and back. Keep that core tight. Try not to let that hip open up. So you're nice and even. Your hips and shoulders are in the same direction. Couple more. Four, keep that elbow straight back. Three, use the core to hold yourself in place. Two, and one. Great job. We're gonna switch sides. So if you need to move the chair, you can move the chair or move around it. Okay, so right foot is forward. Bend that right knee. Here's what it looks like. Okay, shoulders down and back. We're gonna pull back on the left. Here we go, pull back. Two, nice. Three, good. Four, so stabilize that body. Five, your body weight's in the right heel. Six, bend that right knee. Seven, and eight, excellent. All right, now I'm gonna add another element of balance and throw you off. We're gonna use our neck as well. So it looks like this. We're gonna switch sides, hold on to that chair if you need to. Right hand comes up. You don't need the weight. It's an option. It's modified if you don't want it. This one, you're going to open it up, look behind you, come right back. Okay. Bring that elbow back. Use your head to look back as well. Come back. It's much harder. Hold on if you need to. Three, come on back. Good job. Four, open. You got a nice back move. Using that neck too. You got to look behind you on the bike. You always have to know what's around you. Good. Balancing. Changing center of gravity. Huge components of biking. Good. One more time. Yes. Okay. Other side. I'm going to step forward on the right. And if you need to, you're going to pull back on the left. Look behind you over your shoulder. See what's coming. Pull back. So that weight is just adding extra resistance. Okay, so you don't need it if you don't want it. Good. I'm just using extra strength. There's a lot of levels in here, so we want to modify. Good. Open it up. You got one more after this. Pull back. Yes. All right, put that weight down. Grab a little sip of water. All right, we're going to move on. So you guys know my favorite, stepping over. I'm gonna get us into cardio a little and then go back to strength and balance. So we're gonna do those step overs. I call them the sleeping dog. Just pretend something's down there on your chair. I'm gonna have you come up and over and back. Come on up and over and back. So it's good balance, good strength, little lateral side moves, working those hips. You gotta make sure that second leg comes up and over, okay? This is another good total body exercise. I don't typically do these in all my classes, but they're so good for biking, okay? So that's why we're doing these. So if you're still working and you're not with one of us Tuesday or Thursday, it's a good one to practice another day during the week. You could probably practice it every day if you wanted. So if you're really trying to work on that strength and balance and stamina, this is one of the good ones you can try. Up and over, because you gotta use your ankles to stabilize. You know you're in that kind of staggered stance a lot. Come on back. Up and over. I'm gonna give you a few more. That's it. Come on. Take it back. Here's our last set. Up and over. Back. Yes. Woo! All right, grab that water. Take a little break. I'm gonna stretch us out for a second. All right, open those legs wide. We're gonna stretch this, okay? Open those legs wide, bend the knees, sit the glutes back, shift your body weight to one side. So now your body weight's in the heel, in the hip. You should be able to, I'm on my left, so I should be able to wiggle my left toes. That tells me my weight isn't in my toes or knees. All right, stay here. You should feel a huge stretch in that inner thigh. Good, come on over to the other side. Sit in that right heel now, right hip. You're sitting back. Now I'm gonna do little side lunges if you wanna try it. So we're just gonna go side to side. If it hurts your back or knees, do not do it. Okay, so just try it, see how it feels. Make sure you're sitting back. Nice, three, two, one, I want you to stop in the middle, bend over, arch your back, belly button, your spine, roll it up. Keep those those feet wide. Heel toe in if you can. Heel toe, work that strength. Keep those feet together. All right, here's a balance move for you. Bend your knees, hands go on your thighs. So if you feel okay with this, we're gonna stay here. If you don't feel stable, open your feet. Bring those knees around the ankles. So we're strengthening those ankles again. Good. And then take it back. Now stand tall. We're gonna do the same thing with the hips. Hip mobility is really important too for our biking all the way around. So hip forward, back, side, front, all the way around, like a hula hoop, okay? Again, engaging that core, that contraction. I always talk about if I were to come and punch you in the stomach, you would contract or hold it nice and tight, but don't hold your breath, okay? Try to keep those feet together. Reverse this if you didn't already. Come all the way around. Excellent. Nice. 3 and 4. Good. All right, relax. So let's go into just a little bit of upper body. I have a lot more balance and leg strength to do, but let's just do a set with your weights, if you want them, of bicep, okay? So you can use water bottle, canned goods, household products, anything you want, or nothing, okay? I'm using hand weights today. So form is more important to me. Feet are about hip width apart, core's tight. We're just doing basic old bicep curls, okay? So arms are gonna come out. Chest is open, shoulders down. Exhale on the way up, inhale on the way down. Here we go, up and down. Nice job, 3, good. So control it, not too fast. I want you to think of the muscle. So even if the weight is really light for you, think of contracting that bicep muscle right there. So besides biking, muscles in the arms are so good for carrying anything, groceries, picking things up. Good. And this is one of your strong ones, so we want to keep it strong. Keep going. I'm going to give us 4 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. All right, turn those palms so they're facing you. Okay, I'm gonna do a front lift. So we're just gonna be lifting. I'm gonna do one arm right, and then I'm gonna do left, and then I'm gonna do both. Now, if your weights are really light, you can just keep going with both, go for it. Mine are a little heavier, so I'm gonna alternate, and then I'm gonna do both. So it's up to you. Stay with this for a few. I'm doing right, left, both. Do what's right for your body, because this is hard in the front. Good. I want you to be able to lift things up. If your bike falls down, we wanna be able to lift it up off the ground. Good, keeping that front. Nice, deltoid muscles, chest, arms, you got it. One more time, and up, good. All right, relax up for a second, roll those shoulders. I'm gonna do the same thing to the side, okay? So another lateral lift to the side. So we're gonna do right, palms face the ground, left, and then I'm gonna do both. Knees stay slightly bent. So it's up to you. If your weights are really light or you're not using weights, you can just keep going with both. I want you to modify, okay, for your body. Good, and both. Nice, we're going slow today because I want control and up. If it's too slow, go for it. If you can go faster and you want to try it, go ahead, just make sure you're in control. Keeping that core tight. I'm gonna do one more set here. Up, up. Good, and out, excellent job. All right, we're gonna take a seat for our last one. Okay, so I'm gonna have you sit down. For this one, what I'm gonna have you do is work a little bicep triceps. It's kind of a small move, but elbows are back. I'm gonna have you either use a fist, or if you're okay with your wrist here, I'm just gonna have you keep the elbows back, lift your glutes up and come down. Lift up and down. So lift your glutes up off the chair a little bit, come down, up and down. So I want us to remember to learn how to lift our bodies up, okay? So lift up. It's a really, really small move. Building strength slowly, okay? But really an important one. for pushing ourselves up off the bike when we need to like lift it up, okay? So use those muscles, lift it up and down, keep the elbows back, shoulders down, push through, good. Couple more, push, push. Now you're gonna hold it up there, hold it up, lift those glutes up, stay up there, relax your neck, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Excellent job. Give yourself a big old hug right here. Nice, open those arms wide, drop them down, grab the back of the chair, pop that chest forward, squeeze those shoulder blades. Again, this is a good one to help right here, opening that chest. We naturally start to roll forward as we get a little older, and it gets worse when we are sitting a lot or eating a lot. Good, and then hug it out with the opposite arm on top. All right, I'm gonna be finishing with neck stretches, so I'm not gonna do them right now because we have another important balance strength one to do. Stand back up. Chair if you need it. This is called a curtsy squat. So if you think about it, I'm gonna show you the whole move and then I'm gonna break it down so you can modify. So the whole move is coming down, touching. All right, so it's a balance and strength for us, and it's really good for legs, glutes, hamstrings, quads, okay? So first for balance, you're gonna touch behind you. Right leg never comes off the floor. Right leg never comes off the floor. Left foot goes behind, touch. Behind, touch. So you can stay with this if you're working your balance, okay? Now, if you wanna add in the strength, we're gonna start to bend into the squat. Bend down, come up. Sit into the heel in the front, come up, good. So you're coming back. So if you see me from the side, I'm sitting way back. Notice my glute goes to the back wall, okay? Best you can. So good balance, good strength. Yes, using that lower body, using those glutes, using the core. Keep going, one more. Excellent, all right. So we're gonna do the other side, okay? So just use the balance part in the beginning. So you're just gonna put now your left foot stays right where it is. The right foot goes behind and touch. Behind and touch, good. So working on that balance. Stay up nice and tall. Keep that string pulling your head up, spine's tall, core's tight. Nice, now you're gonna start to do the bend. So the back knee goes down towards the floor and back up. Down and up. My left foot is never coming off the floor. And up, good, sit back. Nice, remember, go back, back, back. I keep saying that because I want to keep the pressure off your knee. Okay, so we want to build it up into the glute. Good, two more. One. Last one. And up, yes! All right, grab some water. We're gonna sit down again. Let's recover from that and do a little bit of our neck stretches, okay? Before we go on the mat and get really good abs. All right, for our neck stretches, sitting tall. Okay, use a chair if you can. Use the bottom of the chair if you have handles. Keep your body up nice and tall. Here's what we're gonna do today. Start really easy ones. Chest is open, shoulders down, look over to the right. Center, and then left. So we're already pretty warm, so I'm just gonna move along with this one. Look right, then look over your shoulder, see who's coming. You're pedaling, you're looking over your shoulder, and you're coming back, okay? And now to the left, look over your shoulder, see who's coming up behind us, and come on back, good. Now you're gonna hold the chair and do it, okay? So you can feel you're gonna get a bigger stretch. Hold the chair, chest is open, look over your shoulder, see who's coming. Other side. Ooh, and you should feel, this is tighter. This side's tighter on me than the other. So typically what I would do is work on that a little bit longer, kind of going into those stretches a little bit longer, staying with it and increasing my range of motion. We don't have a ton of time to do this. This would be a really good stretch class, and I'm gonna add a lot of this next week into our flexibility and stretching. Okay, so stop there. Next one, I'm gonna have you sit over to the side of a chair. Hold on to the side. So right hand will fall to the right. Left hand is holding on. Let your ear fall to your shoulder. Stay there. Grab on to that left shoulder. Now you're gonna look over your right shoulder. So you're looking over the shoulder to the side you're falling to. That makes sense, okay? And then you can look up. Down. Breath in, look up. As you exhale, look down. As you exhale, nice. And we'll do that to the other side, okay? So now, holding on with the right, let the left hand go. Let your left ear fall to left shoulder, stay there. Let your left hand grab your right shoulder, keep your chest open, deep breath in. Blow it out, look up over your shoulder. Stay up there. Keep breathing normal while you're there. Take your deep breath in and then blow it out as you look down, but you're still looking there. Now look at the ground behind you. Deep breath in, exhale. As you exhale, look up, up over your shoulder to the ceiling. You never know what's coming at you from the sky. And then look down. Good. And come on out of that. All right, just a little mobility right here in the chair. Hands come up. I'm gonna do a chair pose. Lean forward, lift the fingertips, shoulders down though. Keep a flat back. Knees are above your ankle. Just a nice chair yoga pose, stretching it out. Bring those fingers down to the toes. If you feel dizzy, don't put your head down, keep it up. If you're okay, let it go. And then pretend the back of the chair is flat, and then you're just gonna roll up that spine. Again, mobility in the spine. We wanna stay flexible. Do it again, up, fold all the way down, and roll it on up. Good, let's get that more little ankle strength here. Straighten one leg. I'm gonna stretch deeper on the floor with these, but right now we're just gonna do our point and flex. So toe to the floor, or point straight ahead, and then come up to the ceiling. All right, so this is really good strengthener for the knees. Of course, as you're pedaling again, we wanna keep the legs strong, super strong down there. Good. So this is another way to do those heel raises. So, but just taking the body weight off, focus a little bit more on the knees and hips. And then we're gonna go into the other side. Point and flex. Point, flex, good. Point and really straighten that knee. Flex, kind of release the tension a little. Point, straighten. So if you saw me on this side, kind of getting it a little looser and then tightening it up. Okay, stay with that, couple more. All right, one little torso twist in the chair because it feels good before we go on the floor. Hands come up, shoulders down. Pretend you're holding your bike. Relax your body. Grab on the side, chair, back, whatever feels good. Lift and look over your shoulder. So now I'm just adding more element of a twist through the torso. Come on back. Other side, lift, look over your shoulder and twist. Good, come on back. And we're gonna go down onto the mat. So I'm gonna have everyone lie on their back. Either keep your knees up towards your chest, rock side to side, or you can keep your feet on the ground, whatever feels good. If you're not going on the mat, we're gonna do some core work down there, finish off some exercises you can do in the chair while everyone's down on the floor. If you just cannot go on the floor for some reason today, you can try these knee to the chest, keep your core nice and tight. That's a really good one to do for core. We're gonna be doing a plank down there. So a modification to plank is standing behind the chair. That's a really good one as well. And then of course you're gonna do your stretching here. I'll be doing a figure four, so you can do it low or here. All right, so everybody else is down on the floor. We're just kind of relaxing for a moment. You wanna be on your back. I'm giving you time to get there, relax. Deep breaths in and out. All right, so hopefully everyone's down there. So you're right here, let those knees fall side to side. Again, just adding a little bit of mobility, flexibility into the hips, back, legs, glutes. Bring your knees into your chest if you can and rock from here. Now I want you to rock side to side as far as you can go without falling over. Okay, so use those core muscles. Start engaging those core muscles, thinking about tightening them up to hold you in place. Okay, let's do a really quick glute bridge because these are really good to continue to build the glute strength for biking. So I want you to lift those hips up, put your hands on your hip bone if you can find it in there, and drive those hips up from the hip bone. Lower it down, lift it up, lower it down. So you're keeping the top of the rib cage above your chest down, pressing to the floor while the hips press up. Good. So you're gonna really target those nice glute muscles back there, keeping those glutes strong. Good, up and down. Good, up and down. So really thinking about contracting. A little trick I like to sometimes push my heels into the floor as I squeeze my glutes. You don't have to do that, but if it helps you engage them a little bit more, you can try that. All right. So you guys ready? We're gonna go on to some core work, a little extra. We're doing it now, but we're gonna add. All right, put those feet down. All right, back down, knees in, rock it. All right, get those knees up over the hips. Okay, what we're gonna do here, bring one heel to the floor, then up. Another heel to the floor, then up. Okay, so I'm gonna keep progressing these core ab exercises. You stay at the level that's right for you. You need to keep your back on the ground, right here. Okay, so stay with this, or straighten one leg, bring it in. Straighten one leg, bring it in. Okay, so that's the progression. Try to keep your knees above your hip. Mine are coming in a little bit, okay? And then the next one is hands come behind your neck, shoulders are up, same thing. Okay, but don't yank your neck. You're just lifting those shoulders off the ground. Nice. And then the final one, we're gonna add that little torso. So it's shoulder towards knee. So it's a little bit of a modified bicycle. We're gonna actually target the core a little more. A lot of times when we're bicycling, we're doing all these different crazy moves. It's not controlled. I like this one a little bit more to control the movement, really target the abs, okay? So stay here a couple more. I know I've done a ton. Do the best you can. One more and done. Yes, woo! Hands come out to the side. Here's a huge posture one. Palms face the ground. Slowly bring those arms up overhead. Palms face each other overhead. And then palms come down to the sides. Good, breathe in, bring those arms all the way up. Exhale, blow it out, bring them down. So this is called a snow angel. I love doing these for posture too. We wanna use posture to help keep us upright onto the bike. Okay, so come on, one more. All right, so that was relaxing before we plank. So we're gonna roll around. I'm gonna show you what a plank on knees. Plank on toes or all the way up. I'm going to be doing a 60 second plank, but I want you to modify it for you. Okay, so if you're not planking at all, options are doing a hand to a knee to work that core. You can do a hand to a toe. Or you can try some of the planks. So before we start, I will give you the timer. I'll give you a countdown and I'll give you some modifications so you can do what's right for you. All right, so you can either do forearms and knees, forearms and toes, or all the way up. You ready? Here we go, starting now. So this is the most traditional, is the forearms and toes. So if you feel like you've got too much pressure on your elbows or hands, push that body weight down to your toes, okay? Push it back. And then if it starts to get too hard, drop on your knees just for a few seconds and try to come back up if you can. If you're looking to build a little extra upper body strength with this, you can make sure your wrists are under your shoulders if you're coming all the way up. But no matter what you do, don't let your neck and shoulders compress or hang down. Stay there nice and solid. Keep that core tight. So it's all about breathing in, blowing it out, tightening it up. Good. So just make sure you're breathing. That's my most important tip of the plank. Breathing in through the nose, exhale, blowing it out. We only have 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes. And we're going to sit in a child's pose now, okay? So if you're already on your back, bring your knees in. If you're in your chair, just do a nice gentle stretch. And if you're in child's pose, you're sitting on your feet. Chest goes towards your thighs. Fingers walk forward. Forehead goes down towards the mat. So this is a great stretch for your back, especially nice to do if you've been riding for a while and you have a little bit of aches or pains. It's a great stretch. It's a good total body stretch, but really extra for glutes and back. Good. All right, let's finish this off and stretch out. So roll around onto your back as you do that. I'm gonna just put on a little bit softer music, stretching music that I use. So we're gonna just take a couple minutes and get some really good hamstring stretches, quadricep stretches, which are really important for biking. Next week, I'll do a lot more stretching. Okay. So lie on your back. I'll give you modifications. So it's not really gonna be yoga and tingly, but you're gonna be bringing your right knee in, unfold that right leg, grab your calf or your thigh or your hamstring right here. This is a hamstring stretch. Relax your neck. Now, if you can, straighten that bottom leg. Okay, so it's up to you where you want to hold on to the leg. Just don't grab behind your knee. You don't want to tug at your knee, okay? So wherever you feel good with this. What I want you to do while you're here is think about that muscle in the hamstring elongating. Take your deep breath in. As you exhale, bring it a little bit closer. Okay, so we want to hold it for at least 30 seconds. We're probably already close to that, so just stay with it. Up to 60 seconds is a really good stretch, especially after biking. These are called static stretches, or when you hold the stretch. So we already did a great warm-up. We're nice and warm. Our muscles are warm. It's a good time to really work on that flexibility. Good. Other side, bring that knee in. Now you can have both knees bent and then unfold the left leg. If you can get that right leg straight as well, try it. Good. Stay here with this. Breathe in. Exhale, blow it out. Grab the back if you want to into the hamstring. You should feel good. No strain on your neck. I know you're pulling your leg a little, but really make sure you relax your shoulders. I always have to remind myself that. And come on out of that one. Both feet are on the floor, right heel into the sky. Take your right ankle towards the left knee and open that hip up. So this is all the work we did. Here's your reward. Nice hip opener right here. If you can, we're gonna go into figure 4. Lift the left foot off, interlace the fingers under the left thigh and bring those legs a little bit closer. Breathe in, exhale, and bring those legs as close as you wanna go today. Just relaxing, really. Should feel really good in a glute stretch here. Now again, I like to hold these for 30 or 60 seconds. Nice, we'll do the other side. Okay, so both feet are back on the floor. Your left ankle goes over your right knee and let that hip open up. Okay, so nice hip flexor stretch. And then we're gonna bring that right leg in. Stay here, deep breath in, blow it out and let those legs come in a little bit more. Again, relaxing your shoulders down. Good, breathing and stretching. This feels so good. And both feet are on the ground. Arms go out to the side. Let both knees fall right. Look left past your fingertips. Let your entire body just melt into the floor right now. Good. And we're going to come over to the other side. Let both knees fall left. Look right. Nice. Okay, and then come on over. We're gonna make our way up. So if you would like, you can use a chair to get up or anything that might help. If you can get up on your own and you wanna try downward dog, I'll show you how we do that. So you just come on to a table position. Tuck under those toes, lift those glutes up into the air. And then you can walk your feet to meet your fingers, roll it up, but however you're most comfortable. Nice and tall, and making sure you're not dizzy at all, okay? So if you feel dizzy, sit down for a moment. When you are up there, again, get that breathing back, get that chest open, relax your body, roll those shoulders out. I'm gonna have you hold your fingertips to the outer thigh. So you're not using your wrists to roll, you're using those shoulders. One last time, open that chest. Good. Three and four. Good, roll it forward. All right, last side bend. You ready? Lift up and over. Let that ear fall to shoulder. Keeping the elbow back. Chest is open. Open yourself up every time you can. And take it back. Elbow back, chest open. Good, come on back. We're gonna crisscross those arms in front, get those feet about hip width apart. Final stretch, breathing in through the nose, lift those fingers to the ceiling, and then sit back into the heels into a squat. Breathe in, exhale, blow it out. Two more times, breathe in, blow it out, and last one, all the way up, and sit all the way back. So thank you so much for joining us. So don't forget, WA is on Thursday. So I'm gonna shut our music off and you can let me know if you have any questions.